Okay. Hi, my dear students. Today we are going to discuss the topic is cathode ray tube. Okay. First, what is this cathode ray tube? It is a heart of CRO. What is the CRO? The CRO is cathode ray oscilloscope. You know this very well. You saw that instrument in the laboratory also. It is very important instrument which is used for electrical measurements. Any electrical measurement. Okay. This cathode ray oscilloscope. Before going to that topic, we should know what is cathode. What is cathode ray? Okay, first, what is cathode? You know the electrodes, right? Electrodes. There is two types of electrodes, anode and cathode. So this cathode is having negative charge. Here we are having some cathode which is a metal which will emit the beam of electrons, which we call it as cathode rays. Cathode ray is nothing but the beam of electrons which is coming from some metal. Here we are giving some high tension supply so that this metal acts as cathode. So using this cathode rays, this cathode ray tube will going to work. Okay, first, what is this cathode ray tube? First, we will discuss this part. First, definition, then parts of this cathode ray tube, uses and application. Okay, first, what is this cathode ray tube? Let us come to the definition here. It is a vacuum tube designed in such a way that the cathode ray will accelerate, deflect, so that we can make many measurements. Using this cathode ray tube, in terms of cathode ray oscilloscope, we can make many measurements. Okay, what are the parts? Before going to the parts of this cathode ray tube, what is the principle on which it will be working? Okay, this is the principle. So, what is the principle? If we are having some deflecting plates, I am giving some potential to that deflecting plate. If an electron is moving in between this, if I given the potential, let us consider this as a x1, this as x2, this electron will move towards the x1. If x1 is having positive potential, the electron is having negative charge, so that will deflect towards the x1 plate. If I changes the polarity here, so what happens, this electron will deflect towards the positive side, that is the x2 plate. The main principle of this is the deflection of the electron because of the giving magnetic field or electric field. Okay, this is the circuit diagram, this cathode ray tube. This cathode ray tube is having mainly three parts. The first part is electron gun system. From here to here, we are referring it as a electron gun system. Okay. In the electron gun system, we are having cathode and anode grid. Okay. First part is electron gun system. The second part is deflecting system. This deflecting system is having two set of deflecting plates. That is, one is vertical deflecting plate. This another one is horizontal deflecting plate. The third part is fluorescent screen and glass envelope. This fluorescent screen and this total glass envelope which is maintained with the high vacuum. So, why we are maintaining high vacuum? Because there should not be effect of other particles for this electron beam. So, working. What is the working? They will ask us, the question is like this, the construction and working of cathode ray tube with the principle. Okay. Let us consider the working of this tube. The electron gun system is having a cathode. We are giving high tension power supply to that, so that the metal will continuously emit the electrons here. So this electron fine beam, what we call this electron fine beam, we call this as a cathode ray. So this cathode ray will move towards the grid. This grid is having positive potential. It is having higher positive potential, so that will be helpful for the electron to make a fine beam. It should not deflect. So it should travel in a straight line. Next, afterwards, we are making this beam to fall on this grid. This grid is like plates which is having a hole. Okay. This electron beam or the cathode ray is made to fall on this grid A1 and A2 series of grids, which will make this electron beam is more finer rays. Okay. Then the second part, this cathode ray will travel to the deflecting system. There is series of plates, that is vertical, this vertical deflecting plates and horizontal deflecting plate. So this vertical deflecting plate and horizontal deflecting plates are responsible for the vertical and horizontal deflection. What we call for this? This is the vertical line, this is the horizontal line. So to what we need in the output, if we need the cathode ray output in the vertical way, we should give the potential to the vertical plates. So if we give the potential vertically, the cathode ray beam will travel vertically on this fluorescent screen. If we give the potential horizontally, this YY plate, then what happens? The electron beam will, we will get this trace on this screen, we will get horizontal trace. So for the vertical plate, we will get vertical trace. So what happens according to the potential given here, the outward circuit diagram or outward potential, the electron beam which is traveling here, that will deflect towards the plate. If I consider, I am giving here positive, here negative, the beam will deflect like this. The beam will deflect towards this and I am getting here the trace. Okay. If I give the potential here, it is positive, here negative, the beam will deflect like this. So according to the potential given here, the beam will deflect vertically here, vertically. So that we call this as XX plates as vertical deflecting plates. Okay, next here is a horizontal deflecting plates. It is like two plates like this and two plates like this, and the ray is coming from in between here, and if I am giving positive to this, the ray will deflect the left. If I giving the positive here, the ray will deflect inwards. Okay, so that I will get a horizontal trace. I can get a horizontal trace on the screen of the CRO or this screen of this. Okay, that is the second part. It is having a pair of deflecting system, vertical deflecting plates and horizontal deflecting plates. And finally, the third part is this whole apparatus is enveloped with a glass tube which is maintained high vacuum. It should not, this electron beam should not disturb by the external matters. So we made here a high vacuum and fluorescent screen here. There will be a fluorescent screen. Okay. When the electron beam travel here and hit on the screen, what happens? There is an emission of flashes of light. What we call this fluorescence? You know the concept of fluorescence or phosphor. So if we are having some material of phosphor or fluorescence material, there is a electron which is hitting on the surface of this metal or some fluorescent metal. What happens? There is a flashes of light which is emitted. There is emission of photon. So this will be helpful, this principle will be helpful here. If there is a, whenever the electron beam or the cathode ray hitting on the screen, there is an emission of photon. So that will give you the visible indication on the graphical, that is the graph which is on the cathode ray tube. There is one graphical representation or the visual indication. We can get here the visual indication of the output and input. Input, output of the circuit. So we can give the different voltages here. We can give different circuits to study the input and output forms. So if I get the input and output like this, we can measure many measurement using this visible indication. Okay, so what are the application of this? We studied about the principle and the main the definition and what are the construction parts and what are the how it will be. So what are the application, what is the use of this cathode ray tube or in terms of cathode ray oscilloscope? There are several applications of cathode ray tube. That is, the main application is in the industry. So the application, the first one is industrial application. So in the industry we are using, in the industry we are using, okay, industry we are using it to determine the defect in the parts of the engine. And in medical applications, in medical application, in the electrocardiography and all, in other applications like lab instrumental application, we know in the lab we are using to determine the, to study the waveforms, to determine the voltage, current or frequency in many other form, and to study the unknown signals, and also to study the other applications like phase difference. If we are having two waves, if we consider there are two waves with some phase difference, with some phase difference, we can determine the phase difference by measuring the and studying these two waveforms. Okay, thank you.